Hello guys, welcome to Being Engineers. This is Tomogno, and from this video onward, we are going to start a new video tutorial series on Python. Now, I really value the precious time that you all have. So the fundamental idea or the main concept behind this tutorial series is to cover the basic concepts of Python for the beginners in the shortest possible time, keeping in my mind that you don't feel bored and skip to any other videos. So let's begin. So what is Python? Python is a high-level general-purpose interpreted dynamic programming language. It was created by Guido van Rossum during the 1985 to 1990. And there are two versions of Python available, 2.7.x and 3.5.x. And in this course, we will be covering the 2.7.x version. Of course, if you wish, then you can download and use 3.5 version, although there are some minor differences and there are some advantages of version 3.5 over 2.7, and I will be discussing it in another video. Now let us look at some of its features. Number 1. It is a clearly defined and readable since it uses English-like keywords, which has a simple structure, and it is basically a human-like language and not a machine level. Then Python is processed at the runtime by the interpreter. So there is no need to compile your Python program before executing it. So now, what is the difference between the interpreter and a compiler? So interpreter translates each and every instruction as an input one at a time, and the compiler translates the entire program as an input into the machine code at a time. And also in an interpreter, there is no intermediate object code, hence they are more memory efficient. Whereas a compiler, they generate intermediate object code which requires further linking and hence they require more memory. Also in interpreter, the errors are displayed for every instruction interpreted, if there is any error, and hence the debugging becomes easy. Whereas in compiler, the errors are displayed after the entire program is scanned. Next, Python supports object-oriented technique of programming. Well, the object-oriented stuff needs more time to be discussed, but I'll make sure to cover it in the future video. Then Python can run on a wide variety of hardware platforms and has the same interface on all platforms. Python also supports graphical user interface applications that can be created and can be used in many libraries and Windows system. It can be used as a scripting language or can be compiled to bytecode for building large applications. So what is a scripting language? It is a form of programming language that is usually interpreted rather than compiled. And finally, it supports automatic garbage collection. Well, garbage collection is a form of automatic memory management. And as the name suggests, it automatically collects the objects that are no longer in use by the program. Now, we need to perform installation. Go to the browser and write www.python.org, and then you'll have to download based on the operating system that you are having. I have Windows, so I will be downloading the 64-bit version of the Python. So go to the download section and click on the .msi file. So after you have successfully downloaded it, you need to start installing it. So install for all users, click on next, then next, and now go to this add python.exe to the path. So clicking on this, you will have to select will be installed on local hard drive, and this will set your path automatically. Then click on next, and you have finally successfully installed the Python. So now you have installed Python, and now the Python console can be accessed by running a graphical user interface that comes installed with this Python called IDLE. So if you need to check whether you have successfully installed it or not, open IDLE and you'll see a prompt of three right arrows. And hit enter. And there is no need to write semicolon like you do in C or C++. And if you don't see this, then you have probably done something wrong. So uninstall the program and try it once again. For Linux and Macintosh installation, I have provided the steps in our website, so do have a look at it. And I hope you have successfully understood and installed the Python. So this was the first tutorial on Python, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. And make sure to subscribe to our channel, click on the bell icon so that you don't miss a single video from our channel, and also follow us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram for more updates. So I'll see you in another video. Until then, bye.